you. Oh, that's a nice ride. Ah, oh, hey, you there. Let's roll it. Hey all, I hope you're doing well and you're just as excited as me for the Red Bull King of the Air, which is going to start next week. First of all, today we're going to have registration. Tomorrow there's going to be an opening ceremony, so it's really getting close. And with the Red Bull King of the Air coming, I thought it would be interesting to talk a little bit about the Boardoff. Last year there was this huge hype about the kite loop Boardoff. I finally managed to land it just a couple of days ago. But yeah, how do you get into that Boardoff and how are you going to go for the first steps? Because it's a trick that you can really exponentially build. There are so many possibilities and so many varieties. So let's start with grabbing in the different ways. So right over here, I have the board I'll be riding for Red Bull King of the Air. It's a carved tantrum, 139 by 41.5. I got a custom made for this competition as the wind can be quite strong here. And let's talk about the ways we're going to grab that board. So one of the ways that I really love is just grabbing it by the tail right over here. So you can grab it by the tail right there. You have a lot of grip, especially because you have that fin in your hand. And like that, you can move it around. But it might fly away a little bit. Then the other possibility will be grabbing it here. By the front side rail, you can take it off like that. It does get a bit slippery depending on what board you're riding. And you actually need to be quite agile. Then another option you could do is grabbing it by the grab handle. Unfortunately, I don't have one, so I can't show you right now, but most boards have grab handles, and that's actually also a very easy way to grab the board. So before we start jumping around like crazy and taking that board off midair, let's focus on the kite steering, because that's the main important factor in this board off. You can practice this by simply putting the power line between your index and your middle finger. And from there, we're gonna go to the beach, steering our kite either between 10 and 11 or 1 and 2 whilst, yeah, sitting on the beach. After that, we're gonna take it to the water. On the water, you're gonna go for a normal jump. Instead, just after your takeoff, you take your backhand off. When you take your backhand off, you're going to have to steer that kite with one hand. Just before your landing, put your hand back on the bar and really try to build up that time that you can steer the kite with one hand. After this, you can do a long one footer with the same thing. Then you're actually grabbing something which is gonna ask attention to your bar, but also your board. And after that, we can actually start with that board off. Steer your kite up towards 11:30 and edge into the wind. It's important to take off on a 45 degree angle into the wind for maximum height. You wanna jump high, not far. Let go of the backhand and grab your fin, control the kite with the other hand. And then once you reach the apex of your jump, you want to swing your board back to your feet. Kick your front foot in the strap, followed by your back foot, and steer the kite back into the riding direction and get your backhand on the bar. Land, absorb, and wiggle your feet back into the straps. So let's have a closer look at the board and the key factors to get it back on your feet. Take your feet a little bit out of the straps before you start edging. Place your power line between the index and middle finger as you steer the kite up. And pull the bar down with the index and middle finger. Grab the board with the back hand and then pull your feet out of the straps. Keep your arm bent so the board stays close. And swing the board back to your feet and kick in the front feet. Place your back foot in the strap and focus on your landing. Grab the bar with both hands and pull it all the way down. Land and wiggle your feet back into the straps. Once again, I made you guys a little overview. Feel free to screenshot it and take it down to the beach so you always know what to do. When grabbing the board by the fin, you might notice that your board is starting to fly all over the place. So you have to control it. You can do this by angling the board versus the wind. If you angle it out, the wind's going to swing it out. If you angle it in, the wind will press it right back into your feet so you can kick your front foot in, after which you kick your back foot in, and then you're all set to go for the landing. And that's it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please subscribe over here if you did. There's a few videos I picked out for you over there. Make sure to tune in on the live stream of Red Bull, or just be there in person if you have the opportunity. And I'll see you on the next one.